Hello and welcome back everyone. So let's talk about more on the object. So you can see object dot, what all different methods we have in an object, right? We have assign, we have create. These are not the prototype methods, right? In the function prototype, you will see only these object is property of, local string has on property, but on the proto, you will see all these methods, length, caller, apply, okay, and directly all these methods exist, okay. So this is the object function which exists, which is a core of JavaScript. It's a native. So how you can use all these methods, we will talk one by one. So first let's talk about object.create. And let's talk about object.assign. Okay, so object.create, what it do? It accepts one argument, an empty object. So what it do? It creates the new object for us, a brand new object with the help of object.create. Or like if you already have one object which is having few properties, x70, and you wanted to create a copy of it and pass x, it will give you the new object, right? So let's try to so I'm creating the view object from object.create. So first let's talk about the object.create. X is x70, okay. Now we are creating the Y using object.create, and I'm passing X. So what will happen in this case? So I'm trying to create a new object, and if you do console.dir and if you try to print B, what you will get? It's an empty proto, right? But the proto is again having the x70, right? So this is a kind of inheritance we have done in the object. X is having x70. We created the B object by extending the property of X. So now you can access that value, right? This is not magic. All the properties of X are inherited into the new object which we created as a B. And now you can do a B.x which will give you the 70, right? Again, the prototype of this is pointing to the function object, because we did the reverse chaining. B proto is pointing to the proto of X. X proto is pointing to the constructor function, right? So similarly, you can create a chain reaction kind of. So here you create a C and object.create B, and if you do console.dir C, it doesn't have anything. But its proto is again having x70, right? Its proto is pointing to the object B. B's proto is pointing to the object X. And X proto is pointing to the capital O object. This is called the proto chaining in the objects. Whenever you are creating one object from another, its proto is copied to the another object. Okay, so object.create is used kind of inheritance in the application for the objects. So you can see object.create method, it's a native code. Can I talk more about this? So just pass your argument, it will give you the new object, okay. So you can pass the object directly also here, and the new object's proto will have a 60 and its proto will have object. Okay, this is about the object.create. In the next video, we will talk about more methods on the object function.